I've been a reflexologist practitioner for 15 years, and I think a bit outside the square. I really believe that people don't have sore feet, they don't have pain and symptoms just because the body's giving you a difficult time. I really believe that the body's trying to give you messages, and if you pay attention, then it's not all that difficult to find out what the body's trying to tell you. So people who come along for a reflexology session, while the physical reflexes are on the feet, I believe that the whole person is there as well. So rather than focus on the physical reflexes of the feet, I'm more inclined to think about what issues sit in what part of your foot. So for instance, if your heel is sore, I'm thinking base chakra. I'm thinking where I belong to the group, how I belong, how I fit in, what I have to do to fit in. And then incorporating all the other ways I assess a foot. Is it to do with bone? Like bone is about restructuring something. So a bone problem in the foot would be spurs shoring yourself up, restructuring something. If it's plantar fasciitis, you've got muscles, which is, as I think, pulled in two directions. So I look at a foot differently, and I try and get people to look at their illnesses from a different perspective rather than, oh, I've got a cold, I've got different things wrong with me. So that's how I try to encourage people to think. And putting those ideas on paper with my first book, Holistic Reflexology, it's the eight principles that I work with. So it's not feet reading. I don't consider that I do feet reading, but it's taking all the information that someone's giving me as like pieces in a puzzle and putting it together and giving them a possibility, giving them something to think a little bit differently about their pain and symptom. Some people will sit there and won't say a word. Other people, I really believe that the critical clue is, when did this start? When did the symptoms start? And what was going on in your life at the time? Now, some people can put that together straight away. Other people will close their eyes and sit in my chair for 20 minutes and then they'll get it. Oh yes, I remember exactly. Some people can tell me exactly when their pain started, exactly what they were thinking, because I really believe that, you know, thought creates, thought is the forerunner to what you create. And so people, some people just have a sore foot. They don't want to look past what the messages are, and that's okay, that's okay. But then you get other people that, I said to somebody once, it's your mind has a lot to do with what's creating it, what's created. So you're telling me it's all in my mind. No, tumours are real, pain is real. But I love Albert Einstein, and you know, he more or less will say, well, energy and matter are interchangeable under certain circumstances. So if we deal with what we've got on an emotion, it's right within my realm of possibility that it will change form into matter to give us a greater impact, so we'll take more notice of it. And then you get, but it's genetic. How many people tell me their problems are hereditary? Okay, so there's hereditary and there's genetic. And genes, scientifically, genes are affected by an environmental factor. So could not the environmental factor that is affecting the gene be how we think, what's passed down the family line? And that's what I think. It's not so much the disease that's passed down, but it's family lines and generations of constant thinking the same thing. One lady came along and she had a very sore heel. And the heel, it was the pain in the heel moving slightly up towards the ankle. She had it for 10 months. She couldn't stand up, she couldn't play sport, she couldn't even stand and do the washing up at night, she couldn't drive a car, she literally couldn't do anything. She'd been to a podiatrist, she had orthotics, and she was talking operations. And then she realised, oh, Glenda, I've seen her before. So she came along. The first thing I thought, as I think, is it's a community issue with money issues, because the next area up the foot is the power games and the money. And she got it straight away. You know, it was just so nice. she had been, she was married, she was the wife of a minister. They'd lived in the same area for 30 odd years, and it was time to retire. And this was her community. She was leaving her community. She was going to live a long way away. You know, all the support from this group heal, the base chakra stuff in the heal. And then there was obviously people who retire have little issues about money and how that would go. And she got it. She put it together. Now, within a matter of months, there was no talk of an operation. She was back playing, doing the exercise, all those sorts of things. I don't think sometimes you have to actually do too much about it, but I think it's coming to an awareness of what could be this problem. What's the cause? What's really here? What's my body trying to tell me? What won't I acknowledge? And if we acknowledge that, then a lot of times we really don't have to do too much more. Another lady came along and her toe, part of the problem was her toe was broken. It's a long story, but she came back the next week and she said, I don't know what you did to my toe, but it's not sore anymore. It had been broken. She said, I went home and said to my husband, she didn't even touch me, but my toe's not swollen and sore anymore. I don't know what happened. But it's just a matter of drawing attention to the issue that's sitting in the feet or sitting in the body from whatever body system isn't functioning properly. If someone would come with asthma, say, if they want to come with asthma, the reflex on the foot is the ball of the foot. So you're working the ball of the foot, and I do thumb walking like that. I use my knuckles and I'll do a slide. So there's a variety of ways, but traditional reflexology is a thumb walk, and the body sits on the foot the same way it sits in the body. So the toes of the head, the ball of the foot is around the chest area, the arch is the abdomen, the pelvic area is the lower body, and then I look at up the medial side of the foot, the big toe side, is the spine, and the outside area is all the big joints. So looking at that, I work the reflexes like that. Often if you get a reflex, say a liver reflex is very tender, doesn't mean they've got a liver problem. It means they could be holding the emotions of the liver by traditional Chinese medicine. So you could have resentment and anger sitting there. So there's a whole combination of things that you take into consideration. I wrote my first book, Holistic Reflexology, The Eight Principles, when I was going to be a speaker at a conference in 2010. It incorporates all the way I work. With the idea of helping people look past the obvious. I have sold the book on Facebook to 14 countries, which I think is really lovely. People are interested, really interested in looking outside the square. It's available, you can find out more information on my website, www.holisticreflexology.com.au. I love talking about these sorts of things. I have workshops and I love speaking at conferences, so I'm really looking forward to speaking and sharing how I think about feet and pain and symptoms. Also on my website is a blog, so there's often articles about feet, and symptoms and very common feet problems. So you can find that's the blog at the bottom of my website. And yes, I just like to help people explore possibility, stretch their boundaries a little bit, and look at life from a different perspective.